welcome back to another video on my channel. My name is Trisha, and in today's video, I'm going to be setting up my new enclosure for Bloom, my corn snake. So this enclosure that I got is actually from Zen Habitats. I love this company. I have multiple enclosures from them, and I actually just started working for them as well. And I'm really sorry, Chacho is licking my shirt right now, and it's super distracting. But Zen Habitats is such an amazing company. I absolutely love their products, and I'm gonna make another video going over the products that they have because I've gotten a lot of questions about it, and I love them so much, and now I'm like addicted to getting them, and I wanna upgrade all of my enclosures to Zen Habitats. So that is what I'm using today, and if you guys are interested in getting your own Zen Habitats enclosure, please go ahead and check out my affiliate link. It is right below in my description. One other thing that I want to add is that everything that went into the enclosure, all of the supplies, is from Josh's Frogs. So please go ahead and check them out. You can use my coupon code ReptilianGarden at the checkout and save 15% off of your order. You do need to be logged into your account, and it is a one-time use only. So if you've used it before, it will not work. So use it wisely. So I wanted to try something I've never done before. I had this idea in mind to make a background that's naturalistic, but in the shape of a snake. So it's something new that I just had in mind, and I had to turn it into real life, and I managed to do it. And I really like how it looks, and it also just added so much enrichment to Bloom's enclosure, and he utilizes every part of it and climbs all over it. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump right into this video and show you guys how I set up this enclosure and did the background, and I hope that you guys enjoy it. Thank you. Alright guys, so a little update. I just finished the background and the side panels, and I don't know. I am like kind of upset with myself because the silicone was kind of a mess, and I added random rocks, which I guess they look okay on camera. I think I'm just like overanalyzing this, but I feel like I shouldn't have added random rocks with silicone. But overall, I think the snake actually looks like a snake, so I'm happy about that. I think its little eyeballs are super cute with the little plants. I like how the different colors are popping and there's like leaves all over. So I think it looks pretty cool. I think it will add some enrichment for Bloom. He can climb on this. There's like so many different textures and feels, and he absolutely like takes advantage of anything that I give him. So I really think adding a background like this is definitely going to be interesting for him, and he will utilize it. So I don't know. I'm excited. But I think at this point, like, I've been working on this for so long that I'm overanalyzing it. So I'm finding like little details that are driving me crazy. So I'm just gonna stop looking at it and just appreciate it for what it is and start decorating everything. And for those who are wondering exactly how I did this, because I didn't film it. So after I put the silicone all over the snake, I then put the dirt on top of it. I let it sit and dry. And then all of these plants over here, including these ones over here, they all have wires. So I was able to just shove them into the foam, and that's how they're secure and staying into the snake. So in case anyone is curious about that, that's how I did it. And then I just have some like moss patches, and those are the rocks that I'm like, kind of like, why did I add them? But whatever, they're there now. So I don't know, it's different textures and feels, so it is enrichment, so I'm gonna stop complaining, and I'm just gonna keep going, I guess. So now I'm gonna go ahead and finish building it. So the reason why I didn't put it all together is because this is gonna have sliding doors, and the screen lid secures in on top. I'm about to do that part. And when I do that, I would have no way to access the background and be able to do something like this, so that's why I built it halfway. That way I can access the background, do what I needed to do, and then finish building the whole enclosure. So if there's any confusion about that, that's why I'm doing it that way. And I'm making sure to follow every single direction, because Randy actually made videos. He's the CEO of Zen Habitats, and he has videos showing the instructions step by step on how you set up the Zen Habitats enclosures. So without that, I would definitely be making mistakes. So it's very important to make sure that you're looking at every single step. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish watching the YouTube video and setting up this enclosure. All right guys, so it is the next day, and I finally moved the Zen Habitat enclosure into my room and stacked all of them. I'm very excited. My room is like filling up so much, and it's crazy seeing this because on this side, I'm gonna be doing the same thing, and I'm gonna have two Zens up there. And then these two tanks are gonna be going over here, and I'm gonna get rid of this 75 gallon. Mango, I moved into my bedroom over there on the bottom. I'm also gonna put Ponyo down there too. Like, so many different changes are happening, and I'm just so excited for it. And I love how this looks. It just looks so nice. And they have different stacking options at Zen Habitats. This is the one that I went with just because I do not have enough space. As you can see, I was really cutting it close with these beams over here. Like, literally just fits. So basically what I used is these 1-inch stackers, and it's super easy to do. You just buy them. There's 3 beams, and you just use some tape and secure them, and then you have proper ventilation going through. That way you're not just setting an enclosure on top of it and blocking the screen. That way all of the enclosures get their proper ventilation. So I put my stickers on for Bloom. He has his little corn snake one. This is from Cloud Forest Design on Instagram. And then this one is from Natalyn Bitos on Etsy. So we're gonna go ahead and just take a look at the enclosure. It is looking really good. I'm liking it more and more. I feel like when I was first doing it initially, I was judging it super harshly because I could see all of my like little mistakes. But now that it's in here, I don't think I'm paying attention as much, and I'm really excited to just get everything in here and decorate it and then get Bloom in here. So that's what I'm going to do next.
So the first thing I'm going to do is add some substrate. I have cocoa cradle, which I'm going to mainly use this. I'm going to bunch it up and use it for my plants. And then I'm going to be mixing in repti bark throughout the enclosure as well. One other thing that I want to mention, for like the bottom enclosure and the top one, I have lights going on. For the middle one, I'm using a heat pad for Bloom. So he has a heating pad on the bottom. I don't know if you can see that. So yeah, and I think what I'm going to do, since I blocked the cord on the back, and I want to make sure that these doors close all of the way, that way they're nice and secure and he can't get out. What I'm going to do is put the probe on the thermostat on the bottom and use my temp gun to make sure that I'm reaching the proper temperatures and make sure that it doesn't overheat. So just want to make that clear before I start putting everything in here. That way you know the heating elements as well. So we're going to go ahead and just add some substrate now. All right, so I just added the substrate. As you can see, I just have a pile of, cocoa cradle here, and then a pile right there. I'm gonna be using that to put some plants in, and I just wanted them to be along the front, so that is why that's like that. And then the rest of it is just repti bark for now, but I think I may mix some substrate into that as well when I'm finished planting. So for now, I'm gonna go ahead and pick out some plants that I got from Josh's Frogs, and I'm going to rinse them off and clean them off, make sure that I get all of these white little things out of the substrate because that's not good for your animals. And then I'm gonna go ahead and plant them. Guys, so I think I'm about ready to add Bloom into the enclosure. So here is what everything is looking like so far. So again, we have the two live plants. We have one here, and then there's one right over there. I used repti bark, Josh's Frogs bio bedding, and then the cocoa cradle. The cocoa cradle is mainly for the plants in the corners, and then the bio bedding and the repti bark are just kind of mixed up in the center and throughout the rest of the enclosure. And then we have a worm hide over here. And you can kind of see, I kind of hid it a little bit by this huge piece of cork bark, which can also be used as a hide as well. And then there is a cool hide right over here, which Bloom likes. And then he can also hide within all of these plants, or again, the cork bark over here. And then, yeah, that's pretty much it. And then we have a little T-Rex thing that he's just had since he was a baby. So I just put it in all of his enclosures. So, and then I topped everything off with leaf litter. So just for some more enrichment. That's like my favorite final thing to add into an enclosure. So yeah, I am about to put Bloom in here and see how he likes it. I also have this one stick here going along the whole enclosure. And that is a piece of driftwood that I actually found at a beach. I've been collecting a ton of it and I thought this piece would be really cool. It's nice and bendy too, so I think that he will enjoy climbing on that. So one other thing I did want to do that I didn't have time to do for this enclosure was I wanted to add some air plants. My plan is to hang them from these beams and just have them hang down into the enclosure. So that's something that I plan to add, but I need to go and find some air plants to do that first. So that is everything. I'm going to go ahead and get Bloom and put him in here and see how he likes all of this. He's going to have way more space, way more enrichment, way more climbing opportunities. He's usually all over his enclosure, so I think that he will appreciate every part of this, and I'm very excited to put him in.